Hello, and thank you for joining me on today's video blog. I'm Stephen Pilkington with the Path Home team of Compass Real Estate, and today we're going to discuss how do you finish strong in 2021? So if you're like me, 2021 has been a fantastic year for you. You've helped a lot of clients out, and you may be even having your best year by volume sold, like we are. So how do you finish strong and make the most of this year that we currently have? So when I look at things, I look at, first of all, I want to start with gratitude, and I'm going to reach out to everybody I know that I've worked with, reach out to everybody even that we worked with in 2020 during the pandemic, and thank them for the opportunity to work with them. It's going to give you the ability to reconnect. Whenever you're expressing gratitude to people, they have a tendency to express gratitude back. And oftentimes in real estate, that gratitude comes back in the form of, oh, by the way, my neighbor. Oh, by the way, my friend. Oh, by the way, my coworker might be interested in buying, selling, or investing in real estate. So start with gratitude and reaching out to all those people that you've worked with. Next, look at, so for the area that you specifically work, whether it's a certain part of the town, whether it's a certain aspect of real estate, do you specialize in luxury properties or condos downtown, or are you a more of an investment property person? Are you in the suburbs? Look at what's happening there and look for the advantages. Right now, there's a lot of areas that have really low inventory. So now is the time to have those conversations with your clients or with prospective clients that you're reaching out to say, hey, now might be the best time you've ever had to sell your property. Inventory is at an all-time low again. We're expecting it to get even lower at the end of the year. People are flush with cash right now. The stock market is the highest it's ever been. Cryptocurrency is the highest it's ever been. Real estate prices are the highest they've ever been. So people have the ability to sell high. And there's a lot of folks who are even getting off-market offers. And then now they're looking to upsize into their dream homes. And some of those dream homes, the prices may not necessarily be quite as competitive as getting into your average price property in Denver, which for a single family home now is between about $300,000 on the barely entry to about $800,000. That's the range that most people are playing in. So when people are upsizing, it could be a great opportunity, especially because there's going to be properties that have been listed on the market for a while. People may have gotten a little too aggressive, yet because the season is changing into winter, they're going to be pulling those properties off the market. That's a great opportunity to reach out to a seller, reach out to those expired listings and say, hey, you know, if I brought you a buyer, would you be interested in selling your property still? I'm going to go to work and hunt on your behalf, potentially save you some commission, and ideally bring you a client for your property. So another great way to finish strong there. If you're also like me, you're thinking, well, 2021 is almost done. We really, any deal you have that's going to close in 2021 likely needs to be under contract by the end of November. It's rare to have something go under contract in December and still close in December. This might be the year for it though, because the 1031 exchange laws might be changing. And so a lot of investors really want to take advantage of those laws while they're currently in place and get that step up in basis. So if you're like me, you've got a lot of clients in the past that you help buy investment properties, and they may have bought it for 100, 200, 300, and now it's worth 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, they can sell it at that price, defer that into a new investment property, and not pay that step up in basis, saving themselves an incredible amount of tax. So look for all of those clients that own investment properties. Now might be the time for them to make an exchange. And then finally, you want to start planning for 2022. Knowing that 2021 is coming to a close, knowing that really you've got up until the end of November to get something under contract, otherwise it's not going to close in 2021, we start thinking about how can we make 2022 fantastic. Set aside ideally a half a day to a full day to work on your vision for 2022. This doesn't matter if you're an independent agent. This doesn't matter if you're at a big brokerage, small brokerage, independent, nationwide one, if you're at a virtual brokerage. It is so important to spend a little bit of time really thinking about what do you want 2022 to look like? Start with the end in mind. How much time do you want to work? And I do that by figuring out first, how much vacation time do I want to take, and put that on my calendar. And then I look at, what's my income goal so that I can live the lifestyle, my family can live the lifestyle that we really want to live, and we can make the investments that we want to make that are going to help us become secure in our finances. What is that number for you? Figure that out and then start dividing it by 12. And that's your monthly goal. Of course, there's some seasonality into that that you should take into consideration. And then think about, What about your current structure? What worked really well in 2021 that you can look at and say, this is an amazing foundation. How can I make it even better? How can I make things a little sharper, a little nicer? How can I reach more people? Look at what you've done well. I will caution you against looking to completely revamp something. Almost every time we've gone in and tried to completely revamp something, it set us back way more than just looking at what was successful and how can we make it a little bit better and build off of it. The incremental gains over time will make a world of difference when you compound over 3, 5, 10, 15, 20 years, which it's amazing how fast all of our careers go into that time frame. So spend some time, really reflect on what you were successful with, and spend some time really planning out what you can do to make 2022 the year that you want to have in real estate after you finish out 2021 as strong as you can. So I hope you've gotten some value out of today's video blog. If you have any questions about this, if you want to talk about business planning, if you want to talk about what we do for business planning, just go ahead and reach out. My information is going to be listed below. I'm happy to help anyone and all of you. So, and until the next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video blog.